if you read over in the book of Matthew 23 and 27, he talks about the process. He said, "Woe to you scribes and you Pharisees, you hypocrites. You know, for you like whitewashed tombs. You appear beautiful on the outside, but on the inside you're like dead man. But look, don't be dead. Don't be dead. Don't be a person of hypocrisy." Jesus had a problem with the Pharisees because of their legalism. They took the Moses law and they torqued it. They twisted and they turned to their own understanding. Galatians 6 and 12 talks about those who make good. It talks about those who make good of impressing an outward. Matter of fact, Galatians 6 and 12, if you get a chance to look at it, it's put in note. He said, those who want to make a good impression outworthy in trying to compel to you to be circumcised, they only do this by avoiding persecution of the cross of Christ. They don't want to face it head. They crooks. They cowards. They literally live in yellow belly. I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, we're living in the days of Elijah. We're living in the days where you got to believe and understand it's no more about all this oratorical performance. God wants signs. He wants miracles. He wants people to see the power of God. See, you can't, if I may say this, and Lord, in the name of Jesus, you can't witness to an atheist. An atheist got to see power. You can talk to him all day, but when you show him power, his mind is quickly changed. Jesus mesmerized the mind of the people, even with blind Barnabas and Bailey, even the man at the pool of Bethesda, even the man that was over in the book of John chapter 5 when they came up to the island of Gennesaret. I mean, I believe that's is that John 5? I believe it's Mark chapter 5. I want to make sure I get that right. In Mark chapter 5, when he came across the island, he came up. Let me just search that. I want to make sure I get that right. And I know God's given me the ability to transform the information on top of my head, but, you know, I see a lot of things because I move in the spirit, and I thank God for that ability to do that. The Bible said when they came over to the other side and to the country of the gatherings, that's what they. And out of the tomb came that man was filled with demonic spirits. This is one of the times you see that the power of God, the Bible said his name was Legion. We talk about an army, a legional army. Talk about in the Roman days, they talk about a legion between 8,000 and 10,000 men in one legion. God commanded that spirit of 8,000 men to come out of him. That's the first time most in the Bible you see the devil begging for his life. He said, it ain't our time. He says, it ain't our time. But Jesus drew and declared and decreed when they asked him his name, he's told them, you know, it ain't our time. You know, he's commanded over the Abraham, you unclean spirits, thou come out of this man. For thy name, he said, for I'm legion, there are many. Am I somewhere? He commanded the word of God. And I know I got to get out of here. I got to go. I know it's 7:30. We're supposed to get out. I mean, we're supposed to be out of here. But I'm going to tell you something, ladies and gentlemen, listen to me. God is a good God. He's far beyond more than we can imagine, even think of. He's got the ability to transform and change. And Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, just as I spoke unto your people about that which you have given them unto me to go through the kingdom of God, Father God, I thank you right now that their minds have been solidified through the Spirit. Not that I come with anything of myself, but you may be a conduit for the kingdom of God. Lord, bless their hearts and bless their minds. Bless them to realize and understand that you're God. Beside you, there's no other. And you got everything they need according to the kingdom of God. Father God, bless them. Let them realize and know that you are God. And beside you, there's no other. I thank you, Father God, for the listening ears, for those who have an ear to hear. And that you bless them in their families and bless them in their life. Bless them in their going and coming out. Father God, and most of all, look over my mother in the name of Jesus. Father God, when she hurts, I hurt. And Father God, I ask you to touch my heart. And I'm asking you to sponge my heart, Father God, as I mourn in the process of my mother in that condition, Father God, because I feel I'm in the same position. But I know you're able, Father God, to lift her up and bring her out of whatever condition she's in. Father God, I declare by the word of God that what I've spoken, not of myself, but through the kingdom, I put into the third heaven, that if I were to go forth and when I come back void, touch my beautiful wife and beautiful daughter, look over them, look over this house, as we continue to go forth and command that you have given us, as we move forth in this revelatory, powerful move in the spirit. Father God, these things I speak not of myself, but the power of the Most High God. Join me on tomorrow at 10:30. We got our Psalms report. We're going to go over to Psalms 27. We're going to be breaking that up a little bit at 10:30 tomorrow morning. And so once again, we thank you guys for joining us here at Haevest New Life Church and Haevest New Life Studios.
the truth.